Welcome back. You're watching Cross Shots with Nitin Shen. We're talking about the parliamentary elections coming up tomorrow in Sri Lanka and two main political entities for the Tamil community. We heard from TNPF. Now we have supporters and organizers from TNA, Tamil National Alliance, here. Mr. Velupilla Thangavelu and Mr. Veeravijayendra, thank you very much for your time.
Thank you.
For coming. And so the questions are very similar, except the last couple of questions that are more specific to TNA. The first one is basically, in, as I said in the previous episode, segment of the episode, you know, during a campaign, some issues emerge as the major themes or major issues. You know, sometimes it's politically driven by the party, but sometimes it comes out through community input and people's input. So what are some major issues or concerns or themes that are emerging in this campaign?
As far as TNA is concerned, I think we are pushing for self-determination. Mm-hmm. So we are asking for the people for another mandate. Mm-hmm. Actually, there was a mandate in 1977 for the restoration and reconstituting the state of Tamil Eelam. Mm-hmm. That was in the 1976 what do you call the resolution. Mm-hmm. But this time we are asking for another mandate to push the push for the setting up of a federal mm-hmm. constitution. In which the Tamils in the north and east, which is their traditional historical habitat, mm-hmm. where we'll enjoy autonomy mm-hmm. in regard to law and order, mm-hmm. in regard to education, agriculture, industries, fisheries, and etc., etc. Mm-hmm. So actually, we are going back to 1951 at the ITAK, that is the Ilangai Tamilarasu Katchi. There was a resolution asking for the asking for a federal state mm-hmm. Within the within a united Sri Lanka, or at that time it was Ceylon. Mm-hmm. So we are pushing that as our main mm-hmm. demand mm-hmm. during this election, and we are hoping that this issue will be thrashed out at the level of the parliament, mm-hmm. Because you can see every party now in the south agrees that there's a problem. Mm-hmm. There's a problem facing the Tamil people, the problem of devolution of power or sharing of power or a federal constitution. Mm-hmm. You know, this word federal is a dirty word for the people of the mm-hmm. south. Mm-hmm. But anyway, we, you know, we are putting for that, and we are trying to canvass mm-hmm. opinion mm-hmm. that federalism doesn't mean separation. Mm-hmm. In fact, it is the opposite. If mm-hmm. you don't allow federalism, yeah. they will end in separation. You can see that in Canada. Yeah. What is sticking Canada together is the confederal mm-hmm. state, because Canada is different from all other, mm-hmm. Like India. India is a federal, mm-hmm. quasi-federal. Mm-hmm. But Canada is a confederation mm-hmm. In the sense that they were independent countries or states. Mm-hmm. They came together to form a central government. Mm-hmm. So like Quebec is a state, mm-hmm. And the Quebec people are a nation. Very recently they were recognized as people, but in one country, Canada. Mm-hmm. So likewise, this we are pushing for a federal constitution, and hopefully we have the support of the international community, because the international community feels that this problem has to be solved. Mm-hmm. If even the politicians like Rajapaksa, he says that he will not go beyond 13A. Mm-hmm. No plus or minus, yep. He won't go beyond 13A. But Ranil Wickremesinghe, the Prime Minister, or even the President, mm-hmm. they are prepared to have a constitution, new constitution, mm-hmm. that will give the power, to share the power between the central and the peripheral federal unit. Mm-hmm. So we are going to push for it, and we hopefully we have set out 2016 as the deadline mm-hmm. to resolve this issue.
Okay. So, you know, manifesto, if you take the election platform and so on, what's unique about what's TNA proposing? I know that's an extension of this, but how does it distinguish from the other political party?
While the TNA already agreed with the international community that they are not going to go for separation, mm-hmm. they are going to continue to push for a federated state. Mm-hmm. That means they will not be settled with 13A. Mm-hmm. They want to go for, like Ayya said, that go for a new constitution, and the new constitution that will give power to the provinces. Mm-hmm. And a solid provincial government is what we are going to push for. Mm-hmm.
So, you know, let's talk a bit about candidates. Let's just said in the segment, you know, the strength of the political party relies on the type of candidates. And I know two particular candidates have been on the forefront, both in terms of promoting them as well as on the attack side as well. When you take,
Samanthan, who is the leader of the TNA, he will have a cakewalk in Trincomalee. There's no question about that one. The competition is in the Jaffna electorate because you know the number of members have been reduced from 9 to 7.
Okay.
So that makes people to compete with each other. Mm-hmm. And you know, under the system of preference votes, mm-hmm. you know, there's always rivalry, even within the same party.
The same party, yeah.
Yeah, sometimes it has ended in murder.
Yeah.
So as far as we are concentrating on Sumandran, mm-hmm. who was a nationalist MP mm-hmm. in the previous parliament. Mm-hmm. So we are pushing him because of the fact we need him. Mm-hmm. You see, Subandran is one of the top lawyers in Sri Lanka in regard to constitutional law and human rights. And he has been an advisor to the TNA long before he was appointed as a nationalist MP. Yeah. So we hope and we are pushing for an educated and talented who can talk with the diplomats, you mm-hmm. know, who can talk with diplomats in the same language as their language. Mm-hmm. So we are pushing him for him to win the seat mm-hmm. in the north. And we hope to get at least, there are 7, mm-hmm. so we hope to get 16 or minimum 5.
So you're hoping that most of the people return as well,
of
right?
Of course, you know, we have seen right throughout, you know, we are not like the TNPF, you see. Mm-hmm. They, after 2010, they never contest an election. Mm-hmm. They don't have a member in the Pradesh Sabha. Mm-hmm. Because Pradesh Sabha, they couldn't contest. They didn't boycott, they didn't contest because there were no candidates. Mm-hmm. They advertised in the newspaper and nobody applied. So our case is quite different. You know, the ITAK is the oldest party in Sri Lanka. Of course, the Congress is a little bit older, mm-hmm. The Congress Party. But what I am saying is that we are feeling a strong strong team. Mm-hmm. You see, the idea of contesting the provincial elections was one of the aim is to build leadership mm-hmm. from those ranks. Mm-hmm. And you can see we have fielded young candidates, you know, young graduates. Mm-hmm. Not people over 70 or like that, mm-hmm. but even in the TNA party, some of them are very young. Like Sridharan is young, Sumandran is also a very young candidate. So, you know, the problem is we can't manufacture leaders. You see, they mm-hmm. had to come from the bottom. Mm-hmm. You know, we can't manufacture. So, in course of time, we can draw in more young people into the field. Mm-hmm.
So in terms of one of the other key news items has been around the chief minister in the Northern Province, right? So he's made statements claiming that he is going to be neutral in this race, and also has made statements to encourage people to pay closer attention to candidates and also to come out and vote in large numbers, right? So how does, you know, and TNPF generally has seen that as a bit of a victory for them because, you know, obviously TNA had appointed or chosen the chief minister as their choice earlier, right? So how do you see this playing out?
Generally, you know, even though he's a chief minister for all, that is not really true because he's a TNA chief minister. And what we strongly believe is that he should tell people whom to vote and stuff because he has a certain influence among the people and he's a well-respected person. We personally believe that even though he has made statements, at times he has indicated that, you know, people have to support TNA. Mm-hmm. And we believe that people know what he really believes in. We are pretty sure that he's not going to, people are not going to think that he's going to tell to vote TNPF.
But generally, there's already a lot of coverage about the tensions between TNA
and it's very unfortunate because he contested the for the chief minister post as a TNA candidate.
Yeah.
You see, the TNA who financed the election, the TNA did everything, campaigning for him. Yeah. So now after getting elected, after becoming chief minister, he says he's going to be neutral. We can understand the neutrality.
See that as a betrayal or see that as maybe an enlightenment?
No. He says he's not going to speak for certain candidates. Yeah. That is fine. Yeah. But he can say to vote for the TNA and vote for the house symbol. So that is neutral. You see, he can't be, because the TNA consists of four parties. Mm-hmm. So all of them got together to elect him. Mm-hmm. So he can't say, in other words, is he saying that, you know, people have a choice between the TNA and the TPNF? I don't know. Mm-hmm. Well, it's very unfortunate, but on the whole, his neutrality or otherwise will not influence the decision of the people at the forthcoming elections.
Mm-hmm. Okay. All right. So the other thing, you know, as people who are involved in politics look for is when the campaigns happen, you know, are there specific incidents or specific things that are happening, new things emerging? Are you seeing anything out of the campaign that's highlighting positive things from the campaign trail itself?
You know, everybody is targeting the DNA. Yeah. Because it appears the DNA is the common denominator and the common enemy for most of the...
Generally in elections, you know, the call for change, and whenever you have a lot of people in the same position, you know, obviously it's the party with the most amount of MPs in Tamil area. So, you know, people who are wanting change will definitely be targeting, right?
If the people who wanted change, they should have started with the Pradesh Sabha elections, you see, they should have participated. They couldn't, because they are unable to field candidates, because there are 222 seats
yeah,
and about 31 Pradesh Sabha councils involved. Mm. So they should have started from there, you know. Any party, any political party must participate in elections, because that is a way to build up the party. Mm-hmm. You will have your supporters, because if you don't contest those elections and you only go for the parliamentary elections, people are not going to vote for you. Mm-hmm. Because they have already started voting for other parties. Mm-hmm. So that's a mistake the TPNF does. But of course, they give the lame excuse, you know. In the case of the provincial council, they said, oh, we don't accept the 13A. Mm-hmm. We don't accept the division of north and east. Mm-hmm. You know, they stand for one province. Yeah. That's very fine. Then what about the parliamentary election? It's worse. Mm-hmm. The Sixth Amendment says you have to swear allegiance mm-hmm. to the unitary constitution, plus that you will pledge that you will not ask for separation. Mm-hmm. That you take that oath before handing over the nomination, at the time of handing over the nomination, mm-hmm. and sometimes you get elected in the parliament as well. Mm-hmm. So there is no point in boycotting the provincial election. Mm-hmm. What we are saying, the TNA said at that time, and we are still maintaining, is a starting point. You see, we had to make use of every opportunity to grab power. And this is a power center. Provincial, you can see from the way the chief minister is treated by the foreign diplomats mm-hmm. or foreign dignitaries who come there, even Modi went there and met Gesler. Mm-hmm. If not, if you don't have a council like that, mm-hmm. if you didn't have a chief minister, nobody will come to you. Mm-hmm. So the best thing is to use every opportunity, every tool to advance your political agenda. Mm-hmm. That's what we did. Mm-hmm. You see, if you have boycotted that elections, I am sure Douglas the one that would have become the chief minister. That's not what we want. Mm-hmm. I don't think that is what TNPF also wants. Mm-hmm. I don't know.
So let's talk a bit about some of the general concerns that are raised when it comes to TNA by people who are feeling that they need change. One of the main things is around the stand on international investigation, because there's been some reference to an internal mechanism to investigate the war crimes. So has TNA moved away from asking for international investigation, independent international investigation, and pushing for internal investigation, and also on the question of genocide? Because the reaction that the Chief Minister, Justice Vigneshwaran, got when he passed the resolution on genocide and the lack of mention of genocide anywhere in any part of the discourse makes people question. Are there a difference of opinion on this?
You see, you must give credit to the TNA for pushing resolutions during 2012, 2013, and 2014. You know, what happened in 2009, Canada and Switzerland, they moved a resolution to condemn Sri Lanka for violating human rights. Mm-hmm. That resolution didn't have any backing in the council. Mm-hmm. On the other hand, India moved a resolution congratulating Sri Lanka for wiping out terrorism. Mm-hmm. See, that was the situation in 2009, and that was the situation in 2010. But in 2011, a TNN delegation went to US, and they met the State Department officials and very high-ranking officials. And there, we put forward our case. We said we want an international investigation into what has gone there. We want accountability. So it is only after that, in 2012, US moved a resolution calling for an internal investigation, because that is the way they function. You know, the UNHCR, they don't immediately go for international investigation. They go step by step. So that was in 2012. They gave a time for the Sri Lankan government to come out with a proposal to reconciliation. Mm-hmm. But they failed. So in 2013, they gave an extension, because there was an LLRC commission, mm-hmm. which came out with a lot of recommendations. So these people gave another year to be implemented. But in 2014, without any sort of reservation, the resolution speak of an international investigation. That investigation has been done, and the report is going to be out in September. And that resolution, we labored. In Geneva, we labored. Swandran was there for a whole month. Mm-hmm. So how can you say that we don't want international investigation?
So TNA is still committed to an international investigation?
We are committed to an international investigation to the hilt. Okay. There is no reservation. There is no two words about it.
But it's simply that, they are pushing does not mean that they have to push in every place, even in their local elections. Mm-hmm. Local elections they don't have to tell the people that, okay, we are going to push for an international investigation. That happens automatically. Mm-hmm. Every time Samandar Aya and Sumandran comes to US, that's what they talk about. Mm-hmm. And when they go to Geneva, that's what they talk about. They are doing it as a separate business. They don't have to mix that business with this election matter. We are not politicizing, you know, in Canadian terms, politicizing the Tamil people's problem, Tamil people's genocide and all. That is separately being dealt with.
Mm-hmm. But it is a political issue.
Yeah. Let me add this. You know, after 2009, we didn't have any friends in the international community. We were left alone. You see, we were standing on our own. But due to the efforts of the TNA, we have slowly won the support of the international community. Mm-hmm. And therefore, we had to go along with them, their interests and our interests. Sometimes, you know, we had to meet at a certain point. Mm-hmm. So, for example, last 8th January election for the president, it was an open secret that the international community wanted a regime change. Mm-hmm. There is no secret that we also wanted that change. Mm-hmm. So that is why we asked the people to vote against Rajapaksa and for Sirisena. Not that we love Sirisena better than Rajapaksa, but between the two evils, mm-hmm. we chose the lesser evil. And that had paid off. Mm-hmm. You can see, you know, after the January 8th, some of the lands grabbed by the army has been returned back to the people. Mm-hmm. Had Rajapaksa remained in power, we would not have got even one large chunk of land.
Yeah, but it's the perception is also the changes aren't happening as fast as it was promised.
Yeah, the 100-day program didn't include any resolution of the national question. Yeah. That was not included. Yeah. That was reserved for parliament, a new parliament. Yeah. But these people are saying, you know, this is not done. That is, but our people are able to breathe freely because of the change of regime.
After Sirisena was elected, 5 inspector of police has been transferred immediately. Why? Because they were so brutal to our people. People couldn't do anything. There were a lot of robberies with the connivance of the police. See, what we were talking about, the 100 day is the peace. Temporarily, people have to breathe.
Mm-hmm. You so remember Greece, Greece demons, you know, poor animal. Mm-hmm. Then you know the people were cutting the head of a dog and putting on the gate, mm-hmm. and they were throwing crude oil. Mm-hmm. See, all those they were harassed. Our people were harassed. The army had the power, the police powers, mm-hmm. to summon people to the camp. Those police powers were removed after Sirisena came to
power. And just to point out one point, how TNPF stands on decision making. They told the Tamil people not to vote for Sirisena, not to vote for anybody, but to boycott it. Mm-hmm. If he did it, Rajapaksa would have won because he was the victor in the south. So that is where the TNPF fails, because they have lack of foresight. Mm-hmm.
Let me add that. You know, when you have two enemies, you have two enemies, you have to get along with one of them.
Okay. So
make him an ally.
You do recognize that, or you do acknowledge that both of them are enemies in some ways. So the next question is
Fortunately, you know, President Sirisena is of a different disposition compared to Rajapaksa.
Okay. Let me ask you this question, because I know some of these are past learning, but mm-hmm. one of the concerns for some people is that when a national government is formed, mm-hmm. TNA would be part of the national government, which would, you know, in some ways, you could argue, will be able to push policy or push change. But in other case, people feel that, you know, they'll have to do a lot of compromises, and a national government from a single East dominant has generally, over the past history, has been not too friendly, or has been in many ways betraying.
Let me reply that, you know, TNA leader or someone known as categorically, he has stated that TNA will not accept portfolios before the resolution of our issues. Unless there is a political solution to our problem, till that time, we will not accept portfolios, and you can take his word. Okay. And all his talk about becoming a minister. You see, becoming a minister per se is not bad. You can see the Muslims, how they are surviving. You know, every cabinet, there are 2, 3, 4 ministers. Mm-hmm. And people are getting benefits out of these ministers. Mm-hmm. But on our part, we are always in the, you know, we are not in the seat power. So, but notwithstanding that, we are determined that our people will not accept portfolios
until the national question is settled. Okay. All right.
I want to make it clear.
So the last question, as I asked the previous panelists as well, what do you expect the results to be? It's one day from elections. What do you expect? How do the results come?
I take a minute to answer. Yeah, is going to finish it. The TNA is a grassroots organization. There's no question about it. And they have been contesting elections after elections while TNPF stayed on the sideline. And the election is not something you can just do it and then leave it and do it. It's not a part-time business. It is a full-time business, and TNA has been doing it. And people know TNA. And the word we hear from the all over Sri Lanka is that TNA is still going to come back strong in the exact same or better. Oh, yeah.
And also tied to that, how would things be different moving forward? Because I think generally, whether people want change in party or not, but people are looking for some improvement.
If you look at the election results for the last 5 years, you see the percentage of support for the TNA has been on the increase. Only 43% voted during the 2010 parliamentary election, but 63% voted during the Pradesh Sabha, and about 75% in the Northern Provincial Council, and in the Jaffna electorate alone is about 84%. So we expect a lot of people to vote for the TNA, and we are hoping that we'll get about 20 seats, minus 2 or plus 2, mm-hmm. because in the four districts, as far as the TPNF is concerned, mm-hmm. they are going to lose in all the four districts. They are going to lose their deposits. Like last time, they contested the Trincomalee and they lost it because they had no grassroots support. Yeah. So we are going to have about 20. We are going to go to the parliament with 20 MPs.
Okay, thank you very much. Thanks, Thangavelu Thangavelaya, and also Veera Vijayendra for taking the time and coming to explain the platform. Okay. And also, you know, it's one day before the election. So after the election is over, a few weeks down the road, okay.
Thank you for the opportunity. Okay.
Thank you, viewers. So hopefully, you know, this program helped to clarify. We deliberately made sure that we did this separately, so we actually can go deeper and get the full explanation uninterruptedly from both sides. So it clarified a lot of things for me. Hopefully it did for you as well. We will hopefully, you know, have resolutions to many of our issues, regardless of what the outcomes of the election is. So we'll schedule a show later to debrief on that. For now, if you have any comments, please send it to crossroads@tamilvision.tv. We'll see you next week with another topic. Thank you for watching Crossroads with Neeth and Shan. Thank you.